In the United States, 6.7 million adults are under some form of correctional control, whether they are behind bars or under community supervision like probation or parole. To put that in perspective, that's 280 times the number of students that attend the University of Oxford. Of those behind bars, at least 95% will be released at some point, and 85% of those will be arrested again within a decade. Why? The answer is complex, but one key aspect is that inmates face dismal odds as they transition from life as an inmate to that of a returned citizen, a journey that is in many ways designed for failure. Let's take a closer look. This iceberg model illustrates how recidivism is just the tip of the systemic iceberg. The majority of people in prison are there for nonviolent crimes, stemming from unmet needs that start to pile up as soon as they're born. Without financial security, stable housing, and quality education and healthcare, the road to becoming an upstanding citizen in the eyes of society is fraught with barriers. These barriers are reinforced by oppressive and often racist systems and mental models established during our nation's founding, and that have since been woven into our culture in insidious ways that are coming to light in the wake of the recent deaths of Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and George Floyd. Chief among them is an inhumane correctional system designed to punish and suppress inmates rather than to rehabilitate them. Also worth noting is the notion much of society holds that the justice system is fair. In fact, wealthy prisoners are much more likely to be released on bail and to have quality representation than their poor counterparts, who may await their trial for years behind bars or plead guilty to a crime they didn't commit with the promise of returning eventually to their families and communities. This causal loop diagram visualizes these reinforcing systems in a different way. Here we see four reinforcing loops we've identified in our research. The individual trauma loop illustrates the social and emotional impacts from being in prison. The self-insufficiency loop shows how former inmates are at a disadvantage for job skills and being able to support themselves. There are also impacts across generations. The cycle of poverty loop and the intergenerational trauma loop show how family members of prisoners, particularly children, have fewer opportunities and supports than their peers. These cycles continue as prison becomes a revolving door. Going back to the full diagram, the darker green indicates three possible leverage points to disrupt these loops. Raising awareness of the prison industrial complex would decrease complacency about the criminal justice system. Improving and scaling holistic reentry programs raise an individual's capacity to meet their own needs. And finally, promoting policy changes at local, state, and federal levels would help to decrease social inequity. For the policy changes, it'll be important to prioritize inmate rehabilitation and community health over the benefit of corporations and individuals who profit from prison labor. Looking back at the iceberg model, we see how these interventions could impact the mental models, underlying systems, and themes that drive recidivism. Overall, this process has been incredibly illuminating for us, and our understanding of these complex issues has deepened further in recent weeks, thanks to the visible Black Lives Matter protests and the movement to defund police. Innovative models of success are easy to find. We've identified several in our report. But because our country is so vast and varied, and because the problems at play are so entrenched, so much more awareness and action is still needed, especially now when momentum exists. Also, the work and pressure needs to be continuous, otherwise we'll slip right back into familiar problematic patterns as we've seen throughout history following the abolition of slavery, segregation, and the civil rights movement. Thank you very much.